Hi everyone, in this video I am going to explain about Phylip software. Phylip, phylogenetic inference package, is a free computational phylogenetic package of program developed by Dr. Joseph Felsenstein at the University of Washington.
To install this application, go to browser and search with the keyword Phylip. Then go to the first link provided by University of Washington. Here you find Get Me Phylip. Click on this hyperlink. On this page, you will find ZipRTOS for various operating system. If you use 64-bit system, you can go for this link. If you use 32-bit system, you can go for this link. You can directly download the ZipRTOS and get it installed in your system. For the effective analysis of phylogenetic tree, Java JDK file must be installed and configured in your system. After installation, in the Phylip package, you may find DOC, EXE and SRC file folder. The DOC folder contains the document containing the description of this program. And in the EXE file folder, you may find the programs for constructing phylogenetic tree. There are about 35 programs. It also contains the test data for all those programs. And in SRC file folder, you may find the source code of this program.
Let's see about some essential program that can be used for molecular sequence data analysis using Phylip. For distance method, we have DNA dist, prodist, fitch, kitch and neighbor. For character based method, we have DNA ML, DNA MLK, DNA pass, DNA penny, prodpass and proML. In resampling tool, we have seqboot. For tree drawing, we have drawgram, drawtree and retree. For consensus tree, we have consensus program. To calculate tree distances, we have tree dist. There are two types of tree constructing method. They are distance matrix method and character based method. Distance matrix method calculates the distance, that is amino acid or nucleotide dissimilarities in the sequence alignment, and creates a distance matrix. Then using the distance matrix, tree is constructed either by neighbor joining or UPGMA method. In character based method, sequence alignment is directly utilized for tree construction either by parsimony or maximum likelihood method. Using Phylip, we can create both rooted tree and unrooted tree. Drawgram is used to construct rooted tree, while drawtree is used to construct unrooted tree. Let's discuss the default parameter available on the drawgram and drawtree. In drawgram, we can set various parameters such as font style using PostScript font. The default font is Times Roman. Tree growth, whether horizontal or vertical, using tree growth. Tree style, the default tree style is phenogram. We can also construct cladogram, curvogram, urogram, swoopogram and circular tree. Angle of label, branch length scaling, depth of the tree, stem length, character height and the ancestral node. The default ancestral node is weighted. That is, the weight on the nodes increases with depth of the tree. Drawtree has some different parameters from drawgram that includes angle of tree, arc of tree, iteration to improve tree, maximum number of iteration and relative character height. Here, the default algorithm to improve the tree by iteration step is equal daylight algorithm. Equal daylight algorithm. Equal daylight algorithm iteratively improves an initial tree by successively going to each interior node, looking at the subtrees from there and swinging them so that the arcs of daylight visible between them are equal. It never results in line crosses. Another algorithm to improve tree by iteration step is N-body algorithm. N-body algorithm assumes that there are electric charges located all along the branches. They repel each other with a force that varies at the inverse square of distance between them. The tree adjusts its shape until the forces balance. It is computationally slow and line crosses in branches may occur.
Here, I am demonstrating the Philips software with the data taken from the article, The Complete Chloroplast Genome Sequence of Indian Barnyard Millet, Echinocola frumentacea from Poaceae family. With this reference to this article, I have taken 15 input sequences, that is the chloroplast genome from various barnyard millet, that is Japanese barnyard millet, Echinocola crustalis species, Echinocola oreisicola, and Indian barnyard millet, Echinocola frumentaceae, and from other species in grass family such as foxtail millet, maize, sugarcane, sorghum, rice, and purple false drome.
For the construction of phylogenetic tree, first we have to prepare the input file. For the preparation of input file, first we have to retrieve the chloroplast genome of the cereal crop from NCBI. After retrieving, perform multiple sequence alignment using Cluster Omega tool and then download the result file in Philip format. The Philip file begin with the information on number of sequence taken and the number of bases or amino acids are aligned, followed by the name of the sequence and then the alignment. In Philip format, the question mark denotes the missing bases or amino acids, while the hyphen denotes the gaps in the alignment.
I have already performed the multiple sequence alignment in Cluster Omega tool and downloaded the output file in Philip format. This is our multiple sequence alignment file in Philip format of 15 sequence and of about 148,620 base pairs. I stored the Philip file in exe file folder as cpdna in text format. Let's begin with distance-based method. In distance-based method, the first step is to feed the input file in DNA disk. For this, open DNA disk and enter the file name cpdna.txt, then click enter. This will load the default parameters for calculating distance matrix. Just enter Y to accept this parameter. This will calculate the distance and generate an out file. Just rename the out file as in file. It will become the input for the next step. After renaming, click open neighbor. It will take the in file as input automatically and load the parameters for tree construction. Enter Y to accept this parameter. This will generate both out file and out tree. Just rename out tree as in tree. The in tree is used for tree construction. For constructing rooted tree, go to Drawgram and click on the preview. You will get this tree. In this tree, there are two clusters. In the first cluster, the two cultivated species of rice, that is Oryza sativa variety Indica and Oryza sativa variety Japonica, are diverged from the same ancestor. That is, the chloroplast genome of both cultivated species of rice are evolved from the same common ancestor. Both the cultivated species and the wild species Oryza meridionalis share a common ancestor. Likewise, in the second cluster, the chloroplast of sugarcane and sorghum, that is Acarum officinalis and sorghum bicolor, are evolved from the same ancestor on par with maize, Zia maize. And foxtail millet, Citaria italica and Panicum virgatum, are closely related since they are diverged from the same ancestor. From this cluster, It is inferred that Japanese barnyard millet, that is Echinocola cruscalis species, are evolved from the Indian barnyard millet, that is Echinocola frumentaceae species. In the Japanese barnyard millet too, Echinocola cruscalli variety cruscalli and Echinocola cruscalli variety practicola are closely related. In this tree, Brachypodium distachyon stands as an outgroup. All the 15 chloroplast genomes are derived from the same common ancestor. We can construct the unrooted tree for the same data. For this, go to draw tree and click on the preview. You will get this tree. In the unrooted tree, we can't say from which species the terminal nodes are all evolved. Before enter into character-based method, clear all the files that are generated during distance-based method, that is infile, intree, and outfile. For character-based method, we have maximum likelihood and parsimony method. Let's go with maximum likelihood method. For this, go to DNAML and enter the file name cpdna.txt, then click enter. This will load the parameters for constructing tree. Enter Y to accept this parameter. After this step, both outfile and outtree is generated. Just rename outtree as intree. For constructing rooted tree, go to drawgram, click on the preview, you will get this tree. In this tree also there are two clusters and an outgroup. No significant changes observed between distance-based tree and character-based tree. Only the order is changing, otherwise the closely related and distantly related groups remains the same. We can also construct the unrooted tree for the maximum likelihood method. For this, go to draw tree and click on the preview. You will get the unrooted tree. In this also the position of the nodes only changing, no other change in the closely related and distantly related species. This is how we construct phylogenetic tree using phylip. Thanks for watching.